Testing, testing. I'm sure you thought that I disappeared again. But no, I'm still here. Hi, and welcome back to this channel where we talk about books and art and sometimes just other stuff. Whatever tickles our fancy, you know? So where do we start? Do we talk about this week's book or do we talk about this week's artwork? If you watched this before, you know that I do not know which artwork we're going to be drawing this week. So I think the better thing to do is to talk about this week's book, which is Meet Me in Paradise by Libby Habstra. I have probably butchered her name yet again. It's like the books we've been talking about on this channel for a while have been having a theme of grief. It's not deliberate. Trust me, at this point, it's really not deliberate. But this one, again, is a book that has those themes of grief and loss and the word isn't recovery, it is healing and healing. It's a book that has a happy ending. It's not like the grief, sad, boo-hoo. You're going to cry maybe as you read the book, but at the end of it all, it's going to be a book that really focuses on how you can end up rediscovering life even after grieving and after a lot of loss. So, let's get started. This book follows the story of two sisters. One of them is called Marin and the other one is called Sadie. Sometimes when it comes to siblings, they can be complete opposites. Like one of them is the wild child and then the other one is just reserved and, you know, down to earth and all that. So this is their relationship and their personalities. Actually, not their relationships, but their personalities were the definition of polar opposites. Sadie was the wild child, the adventurous one, the one who took life by the horns, the one who went off exploring to different countries, became a photographer just so that she could see the world and be able to experience everything that could be experienced. While Marin, on the other hand, was the one who wanted safety, craved safety, wanted to do what was comfortable, something that was dependable, familiar, you know, where she's used to and all that. Not to say that either of the two is right or wrong, but just that's how they were. And what triggered that, particularly for Marin, was once they lost their mom at a young age due to an accident. I think it was an accident while she had gone to a new country to I think she was either a photographer or a writer. How can I not remember this? Yet I read this book a few days ago. She loved life and she died doing what she loved. Let's put it like that. And once that happened, it triggered Marin, who is the older sister, of course, to become more serious, to be able to take care of her sister and do the right thing for her, which is, to her, being dependable and solid. So that's just how now it became, those became their roles even as they grew up. But in spite of their differences, it did not push them apart. In fact, it actually brought them closer because they were each other's rocks. And Marin lived vicariously through Sadie. And Sadie knew she always had somebody to depend on back at home. So at the point where we get started with this book, Sadie had just come back home from a visit to China or somewhere, and a country in the east. So she'd just come back home. And the thing that Mary noticed was that Sadie had lost a lot of weight and she looked kind of thinner, more sickly than she used to be, but still, of course, full of life, full of the kind of Sadie, just the same kind of Sadie that she's always known, but still kind of muted just a little bit. Of course, Hashi thought that maybe it's just because Sadie had been through a lot of traveling and she's tired. The word is not hangover. After you've traveled for a bit and now you're tired.
Jet lagged.
Yeah. So once Sadie came back, she told Marin that she wanted them to have a trip together, just as sisters, you know, just to go and relax. Of course, it took a lot for Sadie to convince Marin to leave where she stays and to try out a new adventure. But in the end, Marin said yes. After a lot of convincing, of course. Am I telling you the whole story by saying this? But anyway, when it came to the point, to the day that they were supposed to travel, Marion got to the airport and Sadie was nowhere to be seen. She calls Sadie and Sadie tells her, just get on the flight. I'm going to follow you the next day. Of course, Marion is so scared. She needs these pills so that she's able to be calm on the plane and all that. So she is just a mess, a complete mess. Gets on the plane. The seat next to her is empty because it was supposed to be Sadie's and Sadie's nowhere to be seen. Suddenly this handsome man, which I have to say this, I have rarely encountered male love interests in books being Asians. This is the first book that I read that had a male love interest was Asian. Maybe that speaks a lot about me that I have not explored such books or deliberately tried to find them. I really loved it. It was different. And honestly, I hope I get more. I really do hope I get more. The guy who came to sit next to her was to become her love interest later on. But it was something, it was love that was built over time throughout the book. It wasn't just insta love. If I spoil the whole book, he came to sit next to her. She is like, no, this is my sister's seat. My sister is on the way. Do not sit here. No, but he sits there. There's a lot of dramatic stuff that happened on the plane. Turbulence. Somebody was not used to flying. Do not go together. So she ended up getting to her destination. Well, kind of close to her destination because they had to land at an airport, not at the island where they were supposed to go to because of the turbulence and everything and the storm that was brewing. And the kind stranger, Lucas, offered to give her a ride on his boat to the island. And during the process, now you find out that actually Lucas owns the island, the resort, which is on an island. You find out later on that Lucas himself was also going through a lot of grief since he had just lost his dad due to cancer. He would seem to be a cold person, but he wasn't, honestly. And he was so kind to his employees and to even everyone around him, even people who would not necessarily deserve kindness. He was kind to them and pretty respectful. Marin somehow survived the trip finally to the island after a lot of drama. This is somebody who has never left her home state, finally now leaving the country by herself and going through all that. So you can imagine it was a bit of a turbulent time for her. Getting there, starting to release herself. That's not the word. To become more free and more open, to enjoy the experiences on the island, finally have a holiday and experience new adventures. So she starts her journey, her holiday, still calling back home to find out when her sister is coming. All the time she's calling, her sister sounds like she's sleeping, you know, just like she's waking up, she's a little bit groggy, but still she didn't connect the dots. Later on, she does find out the reason why her sister didn't come was that her sister was sick. I'm just going to label this video very spoilery. You can imagine the turmoil that she goes through, finding out that she's been enjoying herself on this island, living life, experiencing everything, while at home her sister is struggling. She had cancer. Somebody so young getting cancer. So sad. So she just felt so much guilt. I'm not supposed to be here. I'm supposed to be back home with you. Why did you lie to me like this? Finding out that Lucas was in on it and even some random people on the plane. Fun fact, she ended up with a suitcase that was full of clothes for a newly wedded woman. You can imagine the kinds of clothes which are there for a woman who's used to conservative, familiar stuff. So it was just really fun. And you find out how Sadie organized this whole thing to just try and bring her sister out of her shell, to try and make her and remind her how life is short yet should be enjoyed. Just yesterday I was with my friends climbing. We were ziplining somewhere on some hills, and the thing that we kept on saying was just that life is for the living. You know, since you have the space and the chance to live, take it, live, explore, enjoy life, of course, according to your ability. And you do not need a lot of money, of course, to enjoy. It would be nice to go to a private island and stay there for a whole week and go do all those fun activities. But of course, if you don't have that money, you do what is within your means, which is just enjoy life. Marin ended up rediscovering how to enjoy life and how to be less uptight and to be not less of herself, but just more of a complete version of herself. That is very deep, and I don't know how I've come up with it. Later on, Sadie ended up coming to the island together with her boyfriend who Mari never knew about and never even considered that could be her boyfriend. But it was just also good to see that even through that tough time, she had someone who she was going through life with. Now the boyfriend, whose name was it Philip? I'm pretty sure it was not Philip.
It was Felix.
They enjoy the last couple of days that Sadie has together. It's so hard. It must have been so hard. Of course, this is a fictional book, but still, these things happen, and I'm pretty sure it has also ever happened somewhere. Sadie and her boyfriend
Felix
end up getting married because life is short, and in this case, life is short. And Sadie passes on being a happy person, having enjoyed her last days on earth, as unfair as it may be, because such books also make you kind of reflect and wonder, how fair is it that somebody who's so young and so good, not knowing whether she was good or not, but there's so many people who are young, good, have so much potential and so much that they could give, why they end up dying so early. Of course, I do not know what you may believe, but of course, there is religion. For me, there is that hope that you'll see them one day again. And that's what keeps me going when I go through the grief. For Marion, her process was different. And just getting to know her sister through the letters that she wrote when she was organizing everything with Lucas, and finding out how Sadie and Lucas's dad, who passed on due to cancer, were connected. I won't tell you whether Marin and Lucas ended up together. You probably know that, whether they did or not. Who do I recommend this book to? Anyone who is not afraid to cry when they read a book, is ready for a book that might make them cry. Anybody who's ready for an emotional book that has a lot of sadness, but then also still has a happy ending, which is normally a very difficult balance to achieve when writing a book, because you end up connecting so much with Sadie and with Marin, and you see them as actual people, three-dimensional people. And to lose Sadie in the end, it felt like an actual loss. So that's why I wonder how Marin was able to get through that kind of a loss. Yeah, so I think that's the end of my review. And if you want to give it a listen or a read, you can find the link to the Goodreads page down there in the description. And on that Goodreads page, you can see now a list of places where you can purchase the book. I really hope you've enjoyed watching along to me draw or paint. And I hope that I've given you maybe a push to try out this book, because it's a good one. I've spoiled the whole book. Yeah, if you liked the video, please feel free to leave a like, a comment, subscribe to the channel if you haven't, and share the video with your friends. If you would also like to learn how to draw, links are down in the description below. I also offer private classes. You can contact me through my Instagram, then we can figure out what to do next. And if you also have any artwork that you'd like to be commissioned, you can reach out to me via Instagram, and of course, I'll be able to help you out. So I guess we're done, and catch you on the flippity flip.